Thank you. Have a good day. Okay, we've got the management of IndiaMART with us, Dinesh Agarwal, the founder and CEO, joining us now. Mr. Agarwal, good morning. Good to have you with us. Now, let's talk about earnings. Q2, of course, was much better with respect to member adds, now at about 8,000. Was this a one-off, or what's the kind of rate that you wish to achieve? And, you know, has this been an organic build-up that you're already seeing?
So, as you may be aware, that our business was severely impacted, like every other business, in the quarter of April, May, June, when there was a complete lockdown and the economic shutdown was there. At that point of time, many of our existing customers, so if you remember, we had 1,47,000 customers at the end of March 31st. So many of those customers did not pay or wanted an extension of their services during April, May, June, July time. Now, so we, our overall customer base came down from 1,47,000 to 1,33,000, about 15,000 customers at the end of June. Now, as the economy has opened up, as the people have adopted internet better, many of those customers have come back to the platform as their businesses have opened up, as some of the economy has recovered. So I think most of this new addition that you see from 1,33,000 to 1,41,000 is coming from that those customers who were not paying in the last quarter. I think this is a one-time bump that you can see. Going forward, I think we will try and get back to our normal days of 4,000 to 5,000 customer addition per quarter.
Sure. But will spends stay low? Margins have gone up for you for the last two quarters consecutively. Will your feet on street expenses begin to pick up again, or can we expect margins to sustain at the current levels?
No. I think, see, if you see, we our quarterly expenses used to be about 120 crores, and this has come down to about 80 crores. So about half of that quarterly expense is going to come back immediately as soon as the you know, offices open up, as soon as the we start to hire back again. We have to give salary increments also for this year. So I think half of that is going to come back. Maybe some of that, maybe 10% from 120 crore or 15%, that would be a, probably a permanent, permanent means at least for the next few quarters, where we have been able to make certain changes into the automation itself or into the process itself. So those are some of the permanent expenses which we have saved, and some of it will come back, you know.
Sure. Also wanted to understand, the internet traffic to your platform has shown a very sharp uptick and very, you know, repeat buying patterns as well. And that has grown approximately about 55 to 60% as I can see. Do you expect this kind of traffic to actually sustain?
Yeah, so let me clarify two, three things. One, as always, in the last many years or so, 100% of our traffic is organic traffic. We have not been spending any money to acquire traffic or any advertising to acquire traffic. Whenever we did advertising in the past, it was only with respect to the brand advertising. And if you see, even on the organic level, from April, May, June, the traffic has recovered significantly. And even on a year-on-year basis, our buyer base has improved from 30% to 40%. Number of traffic has gone up from 32% year-on-year, and the number of business inquiries delivered has gone up 42%. Maybe once the economy is fully opened, because even today, 20-25% of industries are not recovered at all. You know, we are not going to offices, we are not going in the buses, we are not going to restaurants, hotels are not being used, travel is almost sparingly being used. So a lot of industries connected with those are still under a lot of pressure. Now going forward, as much as the traffic should increase because of that, and as much as the traffic would probably plateau down because of the opening of the economy. So I don't think this traffic will go down any significantly in times to come. It is a permanent online adoption that has happened, and there is a step function jump that has happened. Another important part is that our repeat buyer rate, which used to be 50% around 2-3 years ago, which was hanging around at slowly and slowly inching up to 55% before the pandemic, is now 60%. So 90-day repeat buyer rate is 60%, which actually reflects a lot of trust into the platform and the increasing value proposition of the platform and the network effect of the platform.
Okay, sure. Would you say that IndiaMART has now become integral to the supply chain with repeat buyers as well? And also on cash generation, what more can you tell us on that?
I mean, this is what is our endeavor at all times when the economy was suffering badly, and when people were looking for PPE kit, when people were looking for medical supplies, safety items, IndiaMART came to the forefront and talked to various suppliers and tried to provide those healthcare kits, provide those safety kits, and provide those food supplies when the markets were completely closed in April and May. So I think we will continue to add more and more value to our buyers and suppliers, which will further add value to the platform, and which should result into becoming a de facto supply chain for any businesses. And our motive is to make it easier to do business and make it cheaper to do business for all the small, medium, and large enterprises.
Okay, so on cash generation, that was fairly high. There was a bit of a pause when COVID hit. You're now back to strong cash flows. So how's it being deployed? Are there inorganic opportunities also being lined up?
So, yes, last year we generated about 255 crores of cash, and last to last quarter, obviously, we were not generated any cash. The current quarter, we have again started to generate cash. So we have made two investments. One, we have made investment in a company called Vyapar, which is a mobile-first accounting software for small and medium enterprises. And it is for self-usage rather than being used by a Munimji or a chartered accountant. Then another company that we invested into is Bizom, which is a Mobisy Technologies product. They offer a sales force automation and a dealer distribution supply chain management. There we have invested. And we continue to invest into artificial intelligence and machine learning technologies to improve upon the data matchmaking of our platform so that we can improve the buyer and suppliers' connection. Whereas, just to give you an example, suppose there are two suppliers and both of them are into the similar industry, but we know exactly that supplier A supplies to these particular categories or these particular geographies or these particular price points, whereas supplier B may be doing to different geographies and different price points. So we are able to use this data using the artificial intelligence to do a better matchmaking between a buyer and supplier. So we'll continue to invest in that, and we'll continue to look for inorganic opportunities if there are any that come by, and we'll invest money behind them. And third is obviously we have been a dividend paying company now, so we'll continue to return money to the shareholders.
Sure. How big though can this number be? You're currently at about 1.3 lakh customers. Do we take an average of 5,000 customers per quarter, and can we say do about 3 lakh users in say 5 years?
Yeah, so I think we go by the GST registered SME base. So if you see, there are about 10-12 million GST registered businesses who file, and about 8-9 million people who file their returns every month, every quarter. Now, out of that 8-9 million, if we just look at the B2B kind of people, there are about half of them are B2B suppliers. And even if we look at those 4-5 million B2B suppliers, historically it has been seen that a freemium platform like IndiaMart or many others, search and advertising kind of a platform, they would have anywhere between 5 to 10% penetration of the paying customer. And based upon that, we feel that the mobile phone and mobile computer has just happened. This pandemic has been very unfortunate, but it has helped the adoption of the internet and adoption of the online transactions. All that put together, as the network effect continues to grow, our supplier base will continue to grow and our buyer base will continue to grow. We believe that we should be able to replicate the similar performance as we have done in the past in the times to come, not this particular year or not in the immediate, as soon as the economy recovers fully, and if we are back to 6 to 8% GDP growth rate, we will also try to get back to our previous growth rates as we had in the past.
Sure. Thank you so much, Dan, for taking the time out and joining in today on the show. Good to have you as always. We'll take a very quick break with news that we're still latching on to 13,100 historic highs yet again. And